This channel is supported by Truefire. Truefire is an online library of lessons from some of my favorite players. There's thousands of lessons on there. You can use the promo code JNC40 to get 40% off of any of their courses. So amidst all this kind of fuss about these Marsh reissues that kind of are coming, maybe they're available now, I'm not exactly sure. I'm not sure what happened. I think what happened was that Marshall didn't have budget to pay the kind of normal YouTube people to do demos of it. And so the launch has been a little bit weird, to say the least. In the intervening period, I noticed that there was a few kind of news sites saying that Dod were back, and I think probably Dod's most respected pedal design is the preamp 250. This is an overdrive, apparently somewhere between overdrive distortion, quite similar to the MXR Distortion Plus apparently. This came out in the 70s, and I think the most famous player of it probably Yngwie Malmsteen. I actually used a model of this within the Helix. The cool thing about the overdrive preamp supposedly is that the mids are not pushed, so you get a little bit more of a transparent kind of thing going on. Anyway, this is back. You're able to get them now again. Dod are back, and I think that's a pretty cool thing. I think Digitech are back as well. This is a reissue that costs less than £100, so that's nice as well, because the Marshall stuff is really expensive at the moment, like the Blues Breakers, the Shred, the Governor. I think for you American guys, they're even more expensive. Over here, they're about £180, I think 170. This is kind of priced as you'd expect pedals to be, I think, a bit more reasonable, like 100 quid. So I'm gonna plug it in and see what it's like. I hope that's okay to share with you. So right now I'm just going into my HX Stomp, into my normal sort of Eric Johnson-ish type preset. Now I normally run the Dod into this, so this is how I've been using digital versions of it. So it'd be an amp that's already very much kind of purring, so maybe you'd be thinking about something like a Plexi with about as much gain as it might have in it, or that sort of thing. Now, I'm not sure if this is how normal people run it, so let's just try this to start. So we're going to start with the gain at half, level at half. what you can tell is happening there, it's got this kind of thing where it's sounding more like the thing. And it's not giving any kind of mid increased character. It's already a mid-heavy tone, so I didn't want something like a tube screamer in front of this. Would just be mids on top of mids on top of mids. Let's kind of listen to how much gain we could have in here. So that's what it's like in front of a more driven kind of thing. So I wanted to also find out what it's like in front of more clean. That's a bit more of a Fender. Kind of clean. Quite a big low end there. And it does have that lovely kind of almost amp-like fuzziness to it. You see, as you get past like 7.5, it starts to chuck in more high-end too. Got more of that fuzzy thing here, less of the high end as you go past that. A little bit more versatile than I was thinking actually, because although it doesn't have a tone knob, that gain knob is pretty responsive. And you hear clearly it's chucking in a load of high end the higher you go up in the gain. And the clean again. What a great pedal. I don't know if you like the tones of that, but for me, that's doing some really, really pleasant things. More versatile than I was expecting. Doesn't chuck up your mids or anything like that. I think that's a real candidate for, I think, a lot of people to have a really cool pedal that has oodles of gain. It's a little bit more versatile than the two knobs might imply. Let me know if you dig that pedal, dig the tones out of that. I think it worked for me quite well in front of both the driven tones and the clean tones. So that's kind of a good thing when a pedal can do that. I'll catch you in another video soon. See you around.